You do know what I'm talking about, don't you? You knew before I did.
Why are you crying?
Don't you know?
Yes, I know exactly. Cecilia.
I love you.
I love you.
It's James McAvoy and Nigel Harmon. Hi, guys.
How are you guys?
We're ready for it.
So pumped.
Okay, now I do want to talk to you about your play, but first, Rick, give me a number, please.
23, my favourite prime.
Okay, in that case, you've got 23 words in which to sell your play to us. 23, that's the rule.
Include the name.
No, just between you.
Okay, you're 12.
I'm 12?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know why.
Mystery. Oh, does it have to form a sentence?
Ideally, yeah.
Off you go.
Mystery, funny, American.
American's very good.
Oh dear.
Hello.
Generational.
Waste for a five.
Family. Oh, hang on, we need to make this into a sentence.
You're on about 10.
Intense, mercurial, dark, upsetting, well funny.
Well funny.
Well paced, not too long.
Done.
Out before 10.
Is that it?
Yeah, you're out.
Apollo Theatre.
Apollo Theatre, Shaftesbury Avenue, London, glittering West End.
We never got the name.
Three days of rain!
So key, so key.
It's lovely.
You've sold it. You're both, you're sexy guys.
Thank you.
Who get the ladies swooning.
Guys.
Smouldery, exactly. Who plays the big guy on campus in the play, though?
Well, that's you.
Oh, both of you.
That's you, really.
A double point.
You're the lead, really, aren't you? Well, he never leaves the stage and works very hard. I just sort of.
Are you supposed to leave the stage, or is...
No.
When the audience do this.
So he's big guy on campus. I'm just kind of support act. Comes in and talks a lot when he comes on. So.
That's
and
cool.
I'm very very funny. It has to be said.
Who has the bigger dressing room?
You do.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
I do slightly, but he has a shower.
But you've got a bed.
You've got a bed in your dressing room.
Yeah, but you've got a whole other room with a bed in it.
Hello.
Here we go. Let's arm wrestle.
AKA house.
Yeah,
flat.
But that other room's like a dungeon.
It is a bit like.
Why
you go in there
to go
for sleep? I needed a shower because I need to have a shower in between the halves.
Very sweaty.
Yeah. It's the amount of fruit that I eat. It's fruit's in season. Plums are very
plums
good at the moment.
Yeah, you've already mentioned the plums.
And I spent a lot of the pre-interview talking about plums.
Okay. Fair enough. Now, Nigel, the theatre's not new to you. You're in the original version of the smash ABBA hit Mamma Mia.
Yeah.
Do you ever still slip on the high shine flares and belt up chickadita?
Do you know, I hate to disappoint you, but we didn't do the bell bottom flares when I was in it, but we did dancing in wetsuits with flippers.
Which is almost better.
They still do, but it was such a long time ago, I kind of just
You can remember it.
I try and bring it up as much as I can.
Of course.
James, you've been in some amazing movies. Shameless, Atonement. Shameless not a movie.
Movie?
Yeah, I know,
that's
I know.
Atonement. I wasn't asked to do it.
They're asking me back. They're making it. They should call you anytime soon. The Last King of Scotland, but of course you also star alongside Angelina Jolie in Wanted.
Uh-huh.
Here's a clip of you two.
I'll have a look.
I knew your father.
My father left the week I was born, so...
Your father died yesterday on the rooftop of the Metropolitan Building. Sorry.
Now, wow. Later in the film, you get to kiss her on the lips.
On this guy.
On the lips.
Right here.
On the lips that are on her face, yes.
You're absolutely
pretty amazing.
Right. Were your friends jealous?
Was my friends jealous? One of them in particular was, yes. But, you know, it's just a bit of acting, isn't it? It's a bit of Max acting, and,
yeah, sure.
And, it's just the same old, really. It was...
Same old, kissing Angelina Jolie. I never thought I'd ever hear anyone say that.
Thank you very much for popping
thank
in.
Thank you for coming in. Good luck with the play.
Break a leg.
Thank you very much. Come and see the play. It's well good.
OK.
Nigel Harmon and James McAvoy, everyone.
Shall I tell you something you don't know? First night I was here, I came in the club, got a drink, sat in the corner watching you. I sat there ages and I thought to myself, who is this woman? What does she want from me? What does she really want?
I want a family.
Well, I can't do that. I can't be that with you. I can be that with Vicky, but I can't be that with you.
Why not?
Because that's not how it works for me, and it's not how it works for you.
How do you know? You haven't got the first idea of what goes on with me.
I lie here, night after night, and I listen to you. In there. I can hear you moving about. And I know that you're no more asleep than I am. And I think, what would happen? What would happen if I just got up now, walked in our room, shut the door behind me, didn't say a word, just got into bed with her? What would she do? Well, what would happen? Would you let me round the face, chuck me out? Or are you lying there, waiting for me to come in, hoping it's me and not you that's going to make the first move? Well, here I am, making my move. What happens next is up to you. All right. Well, someone had to say it, Sharon. And now it's out there, and I can't unsay it, and I can't unthink it. I can't do this anymore. I can't do it. I can't be shut out of here while you're in there. You might be able to do it, but I can't. We'll sort something so it pans out all right with Vicky. I'll see you in the morning. I'll meet you then. It'll be easier like that. Don't. Unless you mean it.